Hey guys, Vikas over here and this is Weirdiness. Guys, today I am with a new video around Raspberry Pi. So today we'll have a walkthrough around the latest Raspbian release with Pixel desktop environment released 23rd of last month. The latest version comes with a lot of changes including bug fixes, updated firmware and kernel to appearance. The latest Raspbian has also included some awesome stuffs like VNC server, VNC viewer and Chromium web browser. So guys, let's check it out. Let's get started. So guys, to get started with this, we need to download the latest version of JC with Pixel. So to do that, either you can download the zip file including the OS or you can try out the nooks. And one another way is you can update your current version of like Raspbian to the latest version using the terminal. So I'll go with the downloaded one. I'll just download this Raspbian JC with Pixel, the zip file. I'll write down into a SD card and put into my Pi. Now, as soon as you boot into the Pi with the new OS, the first thing to be noticed is that it no longer dumps the boot messages to the console. Instead, you'll see this new splash screen showing welcome to Pixel. So after logging in, the immediate thing that you will notice is the changed icons for each application as well as some beautiful wallpapers. So you can check out over here, the icon for like the recycle bin has changed as well as for all the applications. Now let's open up the file manager. As soon as you open it up, you can clearly notice the new design that has been implemented into the frame as well as with the new icon sets. So over here you can see it has put up some rounded corners into the frame and it looks slick as compared to the earlier version. Now let's close it over here. After clicking on the application menu, again you'll see some new icons and all that is there. After navigating into programming, you'll get the latest updated version of all IDEs and all. And you should notice something like Sunset Emulator. So this is something like guys developer will look forward into, because if you are working on Sunset and you don't have a hardware, you don't need to worry. Over here, this application can emulate the Sunset add-on for the Raspberry Pi, and you can write down your own applications including this Sunset add-on. So it also includes some examples like simple, intermediate and advanced, so that we can just have some demo codes to try on. And it features like temperature, pressure, humidity, all the present like all the hardware that is present on the add-on. So let's close it over here. Now moving down, the office, it includes the LibreOffice, all packs that is already there. And on the internet tab, you'll see something like Chromium web browser. So finally, the Raspbian has said goodbye to the Epiphany web browser that it was using from the earlier. So it is now coming with the latest Chromium web browser. So now we can move into websites with much more efficiency compared to the older one. So just you can try it out, and under same internet menu you should see something like VNC viewer. So this Raspbian comes with prepacked real VNC viewer as well as VNC server. So this one is simple VNC viewer. So if you are having a VNC server running around, you can just connect it to the server and have a desktop of the server over here on your Pi. Now this Raspbian comes with the VNC server. So if you are like interested to access your desktop of your Pi somewhere else on the network, you can do it. Like right now I am just using one VNC feed for my Raspberry Pi onto my desktop where I am using it to capture the views. So you can see something like VNC over here. So to enable the VNC server on your Pi, you need to go into the terminal and type on sudo raspi config. There's the config window, and under advanced options, you should see something new as your VNC. Now over here, you can make it enable or disable. Now moving down, now over here on the internet, you'd see nothing else. Now under games, same as Minecraft and Python games, all these things. And over here, some stuffs like archiver, calculator, PDF viewer, SD card copier, all those things. And okay, nothing, so nothing else. You can check out all those things by yourself. So let's close it up. Now this version of your Raspbian also features that you can turn off your Wi-Fi as well as your Bluetooth device that is present on your Raspberry Pi 3. Right now I am running the Raspbian on my Pi 2, that's why I am not able to see any options to turn off my Bluetooth device or Wi-Fi device, but if you are on Pi 3, you can certainly do it. So that's all guys, that's all with the walkthrough, and hope you'll find it useful. Thank you, thanks for watching, stay tuned for my next videos.